الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق وخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم حق قدره بقدره العظيم يا إخواني my dear brothers and sisters السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The lecture today will be about spirituality in Islam. There's many things people don't know and they have to be taught and or explained, and most of you know, inshallah. Today we are going to discuss about creation of Allah. Allah created Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from his nur. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a shadowless prophet. His perfume used to come out of his sweat, and his wives used to take the perfume and rub it on themselves, musk and oud. And Prophet, after the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there were people who were there, Ahl Sufa. Sufa means sofa, it's actually an Arabic word, the people of the bench. These Ahl Sufa, like Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa radu anhu, and many of the Sahaba, were waiting and sitting on the Sufa, waiting for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to come so they can see him. So they would wait for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to come, and Rasulullah would welcome and hug each other and kiss his hand and welcome to the mosque to pray and everything. Alhamdulillah. So he continued over time these knowledges of Nur through many ways, through many people, groups, and Sufi orders, not Sufi sects, Sufi orders. So alhamdulillah, we'll begin about Ahlul Khair. Wa ibadur Rahman, alladhi yamshuna ala al-ardi hawnan, wa idha khatabam wa jahiluna qalu salama. When these people are called ibadur Rahman, they worship the merciful one. Yamshuna, they walk on this earth. Al-ardi hawnan, humbly. Wa idha khatabam wa jahiluna, and when they come across a jahil, a person who is ignorant and mischievous, qalu salama, they will tell that person, give me peace. So alhamdulillah, these people, there is ibadur Rahman, with the worship of the Rahman, that is the most kind, Allah, and there is ibadur shaitan, which is the ibadah, thinking they are worshipping Allah, but actually they are worshipping what shaitan is telling them to worship. Nothing resembles Allah. He does not need any of the six dimensions. He did not come to earth. Allah has no son, has no father, has no God. We are all children of God, metaphorically. And we did not come from the apes. We came from heaven. Adam and Eve were from heaven. They were brought down to earth for a mistake, but not a sin. We do not have any original sin in us, all mankind. Alhamdulillah. These people, ibadur Rahman, when you come across them and when you meet them, these people who are very kind, they look at you from head to toe and they see where is your wounds, where is your pain, where is your suffering, and they pray to Allah for you to get healed and get whatever you want in this world and hereafter. Verily also we'll talk about Allah, Awliya Allah. Awliya Allah are friends of God. Allah has brought them to this earth, given them nur, given them powers, which is called karama. Miracles from Allah, it is called mu'jiza. Miracle from Prophet is called mu'jiza. And karama is miracles from Awliya Allah. Istidraj is miracles performed by Hindus or other people, like they would poke themselves with knives and this and that. Also the Rifa'i and the Qadiriya, they do that sometimes. And tariqa of Ahmad bin Alwan in Yemen. You have to be kind, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very kind. We follow the habits of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. sallallahu alayhi wa sallam means peace be upon him. Prophet Muhammad was the best man ever created on this earth. He was kind, he was generous, he was loving, he was caring, he had the best conduct, he had the best manners, he was handsome, he was beautiful to be around with. He was escorted by angels, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam visited Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam 75,000 times during the period of 23 years of Islam. That's why we're here to be the people of Ibadur Rahman. And awliya Allah, they have powers, they can see distance, they can feel things, they can know what you did yesterday and day before yesterday, last year, at a certain time, at a certain place. They know you from Alam al-Arwah, from the world of the universe, seas, universes. From Alam al-Arwah, When our souls were created, Allah asked all the souls, Alastu bi Rabbikum, am I not your Lord? Qalu bala. They all said yes, but the first one who said yes was Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah, Habibullah. Today we look down upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We read all kind of books of histories of this kind, this man, that man, who will bring no value to you. Do you know your Prophet? Do you know his full name? Do you know where is Allah? Who is Allah? Is Allah everywhere? No. Allah exists without a place, without a how, without a beginning, without an ending. He does not move, he does not use, and not in need of the sixth dimension. Nothing looks like Allah. We will see Allah on the day of judgment. Prophet Muhammad brought us Nur, meaning light, guidance, love, peace. And the Quran is a book of Nur, the book of light, which will guide you and show you the way how to live according to Allah's way and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as an example for us to follow. And awliya Allah radhiallahu anhu, many who have died, they are still alive in the graves, they can come from the graves and visit anyone. There's no life after death in Islam. There is life after death in Islam. We are not reincarnated. When you're born, when first you're put in Alam al-Arwah, the world of the souls, or the realms of the souls, then when your mother gets pregnant, it's your time to go, you're taken up by the angel from Alam al-Arwah and put in your mother's stomach. If we met in Alam al-Arwah nicely, and we will meet on this world nicely. So awliya Allah know that, and they know which time you'll come to them, knock their door, and receive light, nur, from him. Not because he wants to collect murids. These are not our people. And we do not want to follow those ways. We want love. That is the bayah. Hub. Then you will see karama, you will see healing, you will see nur, you will see Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam visit you. And the most important thing is salawat ala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning saying Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali wa sahbi wa sallam. If you say it once, Allah blesses you 10 times. If you say 10 times, Allah blesses you 100 times. If you say 100 times, Allah will bless you 1,000 times. And in each blessing, there is a different light, different burhan. Burhan means light in you. You know, and like you glow from inside when you send peace and blessings upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.